He said you were the best in the parsec.
Freeze!
No!
Drop your weapons!
No, pardon. Sorry, I didn't mean to alarm.
Ah, yeah. Hey, everybody. How's it going? Today we are learning English with The Mandalorian, a bounty hunter from the Star Wars universe. A bounty hunter is someone who captures or kills targets, usually a fugitive, criminal, or animal, in exchange for a reward. While the person is called a bounty hunter, the activity is called bounty hunting. Here's another cool word for you.
Please lower your blaster.
Have them lower theirs first.
We have you 4-1.
I like those odds.
The odds means the probability. As you can see, the Mandalorian is surrounded by 4 enemies. What are the odds or the probability that he would win? According to him, it's very high, because he says,
I like those odds.
Keep watching today's lesson to learn even more cool words. First, you'll watch the scenes with subtitles. Then, we'll teach you the most important vocabulary, grammar, and pronunciation from the scenes. Finally, you'll watch the scenes again without subtitles and answer some quiz questions. But before we get started, make sure you hit that subscribe button and bell down below, because every week we put out lessons like this to help you understand your favorite movies and TV series without getting lost, without missing the jokes, and of course without subtitles. So join our community of over 7 million learners by subscribing right now. So now let's get started with The Mandalorian.
Beskar?
Go ahead. It's real. This is only a down payment. I have a comptono of Beskar waiting for you upon delivery of the asset.
Alive?
Yes, alive. Although I acknowledge that bounty hunting is a complicated profession. This being the case, proof of termination is also acceptable for a lower fee.
That is not what we agreed upon.
I'm simply being pragmatic.
Let's see the puck.
I'm afraid discretion dictates a less traditional agreement. We can only offer you a tracking fob.
What's the chain code?
We can only provide the last 4 digits.
Beskar?
Go ahead. It's real. This is only a down payment.
In the series, Beskar is a special material made of steel that is used in Mandalorian armor. This material makes the armor incredibly resistant to blaster shots and lightsaber strikes. Here's another clip where the word Beskar is used.
That Beskar is enough to make a handsome replacement for your armor. Unfortunately, finding a Mandalorian in these trying times is more difficult than finding the steel.
Beskar?
Go ahead. It's real. This is only a down payment.
The Imperial officer, also known as the Client, wants the Mandalorian to find a specific creature that is sensitive to the Force. He then offers the Mandalorian 1 Beskar as down payment for the service. A down payment is an initial payment you usually make for something large and expensive, like a house, for example. Check out this sentence. When I bought my first house, I made a down payment of 20%. Check out this clip from Modern Family, where Cam and Mitchell are discussing buying an apartment.
Something will come up. You're a great lawyer.
Thank you. I don't think that we can get that apartment right now.
Of course we can. We already have the down payment. And you know what? We could get renters.
I have a comptono of Beskar waiting for you upon delivery of the asset.
Alive.
The Client refers to the creature the Mandalorian has to capture as the asset. An asset is a valuable or useful thing or person. Check out this clip from the classic Star Wars movie, The Empire Strikes Back, where the Emperor is talking to Darth Vader about Luke Skywalker.
If he could be turned, he would become a powerful ally.
Yes, he would be a great asset. Can it be done?
This word is also commonly used in the context of business and work. For example, with all his talents, skills, and experience, he is a great asset to the company. In the Star Wars universe, a chemtono is a kind of security container used for storing valuable things. The client is promising a chemtono full of Baskars once the Mandalorian delivers the asset.
Alive.
Yes, alive. Although I acknowledge that bounty hunting is a complicated profession.
I've already explained the meaning of bounty hunting at the beginning of the video, but the pronunciation here is also nice to point out. We normally hear bounty hunting with the T's being fully pronounced. But sometimes, some native speakers might drop those T's and say bounty hunting. Bounty hunting.
You know, I'm having a really rough time lately, and bounty hunting is the one thing that actually makes sense to me, so can we please just do our job?
This being the case, proof of termination is also acceptable for a lower fee.
Okay, first the definitions. If you can prove something, you have proof. To prove is the verb, while proof is the noun form of the word. The same goes for termination. This is the noun for to terminate, which in this context means to kill. But that's not what I want to draw your attention to. Here's a question for you. Which sentence is more formal? She applied for the job and she was clearly a bit disappointed when she heard they turned her down. She wasn't able to hide her disappointment at their rejection of her application. Sentence B is more formal. Why? Because it uses more nouns. You know, usually you don't have to be extremely formal when you communicate with people every day, but sometimes you do need to be a little more formal. If you want to sound more formal in English, be it in speaking or writing, use more nouns instead of adjectives and verbs. Now let's compare these two sentences. Informal. She applied for the job. Formal, her application. Informal, she was clearly a bit disappointed. Formal, she was unable to hide her disappointment. Informal, they turned her down. Formal, rejection. Also, notice that if you use more nouns in your sentences, not only will you sound more formal, but also more concise. Using nouns is a great way to speak more concisely because you can communicate more ideas with fewer words. Look at the number of words each sentence has. As you can see, the client in the scene speaks in a more formal way because he uses more nouns. Check it out.
I have a comptono of Beskar. Waiting for you upon delivery of the asset.
Alive.
This being the case, proof of termination is also acceptable for a lower fee. I'm afraid discretion dictates a less traditional agreement.
You know, the Star Wars franchise has become so popular that many other movies and series have already referenced it somehow. And you know, I just remembered a very funny clip from Friends where Ross tells Rachel about his fantasy with Princess Leia and the gold bikini. Do you remember that scene? I think he's referencing Star Wars Return of the Jedi. Check it out.
Do you remember the scene with Jabba the Hutt? Well, Jabba had as his prisoner, Princess Leia. Princess Leia was wearing this gold bikini thing. It was pretty cool.
By the way, did you know that we have an entire course based on the TV series Friends? If you want to be more guided in your English learning, do check it out. I'm sure you're gonna love it. You know, I wish I had something like this back in the day when I was still at an intermediate level. I would watch a lot of TV series to practice my English, but I had to learn pretty much alone. If I'd had something like the Fluent with Friends course back then, my English would have improved much faster. Our course guides you through every episode of the first two seasons of Friends, teaching you the most important vocabulary, pronunciation, grammar, and cultural aspects you need to know in order to take your English to the next level. Many academic studies say that Friends is the best TV series out there to learn English with. So don't wait any longer to start taking your English to the next level while having a ton of fun. And the cool thing is that you can get started today with our free 3-part masterclass. Just click up here or down in the description below to sign up right now. Go check it out.
That is not what we agreed upon.
I'm simply being pragmatic.
A pragmatic person solves problems in a practical way by looking at the situation realistically and ignoring idealistic principles.
I find the notion of romantic love to be an unnecessary cultural construct that adds no value to human relationships.
Amy Farrah Fowler, that's the most pragmatic thing anyone has ever said to me.
Let's see the puck.
In the real world, a puck usually refers to a small, hard rubber disc that is used instead of a ball in the sport of ice hockey. In Star Wars, a hollow puck, also known as a bounty puck, is a small, holographic device used by Mandalorians to see the details of a bounty. It's like a report about the creature or asset the Mandalorian has to capture.
I picked up this bounty puck before I left the mid-rim. Fennec Shand, an assassin? Heard she's been on the run ever since the New Republic put all her employers in lockdown.
I'm afraid discretion dictates a less traditional agreement.
If someone is discreet, this person shows discretion. This means this person doesn't share much personal or sensitive information. In other words, this person is careful not to attract too much attention by keeping something secret.
Absolute discretion. Can I count on that?
Always.
Raymond Tusk. The president wants to tap him as the new VP. You and I cannot let that happen.
I'm afraid discretion dictates a less traditional agreement.
In this context, since the client wants discretion, he needs to make a less traditional deal with the Mandalorian. You can use the word dictate to say that a principle or order must be obeyed or followed.
Hey man, it's cool if you just call me Will, man.
Master William, tradition dictates that a clean, unbreakable line be drawn between a family and their butler.
We can only offer you a tracking fob.
What's the chain code?
We can only provide the last 4 digits.
In the real world, the word fob is more commonly associated with the term key fob, a small electronic device used typically in place of a key to unlock a door or a car, for example. In the series, tracking fobs are short-range sensors used by bounty hunters to track their target. Bounty hunters who take on assignments gain access to their target's chain code, an identification marker that gives the bounty hunter more information about the target.
I know the name.
Yeah, well, I followed this tracking fob here. Now the positional data suggests she's headed out beyond the Dune Sea. Should be an easy job.
Here's a fun fact for you. Did you know that Pedro Pascal plays the Mandalorian in the series? He became prominent or famous after playing Oberyn Martell in Game of Thrones. After that show, he did many others like Narcos and more recently The Last of Us. Pretty cool, isn't it?
Their age? That's all you can give me?
Yes, they're 50 years old. We can also give you last reported positional data. Between that and the fob, a man of your skill should make short work of this. The Beskar belongs back into the hands of a Mandalorian. It is good to restore the natural order of things after a period of such disarray. Don't you agree? We can also give you last reported positional data.
The last reported positional data is the last time someone had reported about the location of the target. In other words, where the target was last seen. The pronunciation of the word data is also important to point out. There are two main ways to pronounce this word. Data or data and data.
Between that and the fob, a man of your skill should make short work of this.
The client is saying that even though the Mandalorian doesn't have much information about the target, he's skilled enough to get the job done. To make short work of something is an expression that means to finish something or deal with it quickly and effectively.
We'll make short work of these tin cans.
No, there's too many, Zeb. If you blast one, you'll wake them all up.
It is good to restore the natural order of things after a period of such disarray. Don't you agree?
What is a possible antonym for the word restore? Save? Damage? Build? When you restore something, you bring it back to a previous state. You can see this word in a lot of sci-fi movies, usually talking about restoring power, restoring signal, restoring order, etc.
Signal restored.
A former British Army colonel turned eco-terrorist, obsessed with restoring the natural order. And to fund his operations, he began trafficking in a new and dangerous market.
It is good to restore the natural order of things after a period of such disarray. Don't you agree?
Disarray refers to a situation that is messy and confused, lacking organization. If you say that a situation, a place, or something is in disarray, you're saying that it's a complete mess.
They're eating themselves alive. The New Republic is in complete disarray, and we grow stronger.
You know, one of the best ways to absorb new information you learn is by talking about it. So why don't you share one cool thing you learned today in the comment section below? I'm curious to see what most stuck out to you. All right, so now you're gonna watch the scenes again without subtitles to test your listening skills and answer some quiz questions I have prepared for you. Ready? Let's do it.
Yes, alive, although I acknowledge that bounty hunting is a complicated profession. This being the case, proof of termination is also acceptable for a lower fee.
That is not what we agreed upon.
What is the verb form of the word proof? Proofing? Prove? Disprove?
Yes, alive. Although I acknowledge that bounty hunting is a complicated profession, this being the case, proof of termination is also acceptable for a lower fee.
That is not what we agreed upon.
I'm simply being pragmatic.
Let's see the puck.
I'm afraid discretion dictates a less traditional agreement. We can only offer you a tracking fob.
A pragmatic person focuses on What's ideal? What's practical?
Their age? That's all you can give me?
Yes, they are 50 years old. We can also give you last reported positional data between that and the fob. A man of your skill should make short work of this.
To make short work of something means to do something slowly and carefully, to do something with difficulty, to do something quickly and effectively. Awesome, you've made it until the end of the lesson. Congratulations, you rock. Don't forget to like this video, share this video with a friend who's also learning English, and subscribe to the channel if you're not subscribed yet. And if you want to keep learning English while having a lot of fun, check out this lesson next.
Hey, Rach.
I believe that this is your red sweater?
No. This is my red sweater.
Oh, no.
What's going on, Rach?
Nothing. Phoebe kind of made a mistake.
You know, I'm actually glad Phoebe called. I know we broke up because you thought I wasn't mature enough, but I've really grown up, and I think we should get back together. I'm ready for more.
Tag.
Come on, Rach. Let's give it another try.
I'm having a baby.
Oh.